Hello students, let's continue our chapter oscillations, and today we are going to discuss that uniform circular motion. Also in uniform circular motion we can have simple harmonic motion. Okay, so if we take a projection on any of the axis, that projection is having simple harmonic motion. For example, there is a circular motion like this. Suppose there is a particle P having mass m, है ना, and it is rotating in a circular path. Suppose we consider this circular motion in xy plane. Suppose this is x axis and this is y axis. So suppose there is any particle P, it is having circular motion in the xy plane. Okay, it is having circular motion in the xy plane. Suppose the particle is starting its rotational motion from this point. Okay, so suppose the particle is at point P. Okay, suppose the particle is at point P and this point P is at some angle from the x-axis, na? This point P is at some angle from the x-axis. Okay. Suppose this angle is, phi naught. Okay, suppose this angle is phi naught. It means when we are starting to observe the motion of particle, suppose it is at some angle phi naught with the x-axis. Okay, so suppose after some time the particle moves from point P to point A. Okay, suppose the particle moves from point P to point A. Suppose this A point is at an angle of theta. Okay, suppose this A point is at an angle of theta. Okay, so this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Here is any particle or an object which is having the circular motion. Okay, so this particle is at an angle phi naught. Okay, this particle is at an initial angle phi naught. Suppose after some time the particle moves from point P to point A. It is rotating like this in the anti-clockwise manner. Okay, so after some time the particle moves from point P to point A. Suppose it has displaced through some angular displacement theta. Okay, it has displaced through some angular displacement theta. Okay, so if we take projection of the particle at any of the axis, suppose the projection is taken along the y-axis. Okay, projection is making an angle perpendicular line on the axis. Okay, suppose on the x-axis we make an angle of 90 degrees. On the x-axis we make an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, so when the particle is at point P, suppose this O point is the mean position. This O point is the mean position. So when we take a perpendicular and the x-axis, then this projection, the perpendicular taken, is at some distance from the mean position, na? This projection is at some distance from the mean position. Okay, suppose this distance is x1. Okay, suppose this distance is x1. Okay, now the particle has moved through some angular displacement which is theta, and it has moved to a new point which is A. So take another projection at point A now. Okay, so take a perpendicular on the x-axis again. Now this projection is at some distance from the mean position, na? So this mean position, this distance is suppose x2. Okay, similarly if the particle moves further, suppose at point Q, again we take a projection on x-axis. Now this will be at a distance of this much distance from the mean position. Okay, and when the particle reaches on the y-axis, this point R. Okay, now the particle take a projection on the x-axis, the particle will be at mean position. Okay, so when the particle is at this position, suppose this is the B point. Okay, when the particle is at B point, this is the mean position, so particle is at a distance, so suppose x. So when the particle moves in anti-clockwise manner, the value of x is decreasing. When the particle is at B, x is the distance of the projection from the mean position. Okay, x is the distance of projection from the mean position. This O point is the mean position. Okay, so when the particle is at point B, the particle is at a distance of x from the mean position. When it moves through some angular displacement, suppose it reaches to a point P point, okay, then it will be at a displacement of x1. It means we have taken a projection here, and this projection is at a distance of, at a displacement of x1. Again, now particle has shifted along the circular motion to a new point, which is A. Again take a projection, and so now the particle is at a distance, this much distance from the mean position. Now take the particle in anti further away in the anti-clockwise direction. Now the particle reaches to the point Q, take the projection. It means projection means making an angle of 90 degree with the x-axis. So this is the projection. Now it means the distance x is decreasing when the particle moves from point B to P, A, Q, R. Okay. Suppose now the particle reaches to a new point S. Again take a projection on the x-axis. So this is the projection on x-axis. Hai na? So this is the displacement. Hai na? This is the displacement. Now take a new point. Again, suppose the particle has come to the point T. Now again take a projection on the x-axis. Okay. This is again the displacement of the particle. So we observe that while the particle is rotating along a circular path, okay, while the particle is rotating along a circular path, its projection is moving like this. First of all, it was at B point, and this is mean position O, and suppose this is extreme position D. Okay, so initially the particle was at B point and the projection was at B point, then it will move further and will go to the mean position. When the particle reaches at point R, then projection is at point O only. Now when the particle moves further, projection value of displacement increases, value of displacement increases, then it will reaches to maximum. When it goes in further direction, suppose it reaches to point E, again take projection on the x-axis. Now the value of x is decreasing, so projection will go in the reverse direction, and again it will go in the reverse direction. So the projection on taken on the x-axis is oscillating like this na, between two extreme position B and D. Okay, the projection is having the to and fro motion. Okay, and this is periodic also, and it can be represented in terms of sine and cosine function also. So this this type of motion is harmonic also. Okay, so the circular, if in the circular motion, if we take projection on the x or y axis, similar thing we can prove by taking projection on y-axis. Suppose the particle was initially at point B. Now we will start taking the projection at y-axis. Okay, so if we take the projection at y-axis, it is at mean position only. When the particle reaches at point C, again take projection on y-axis. Initially the displacement is zero. Now the particle has moved through some distance now, so the displacement is increasing. Value here, the suppose this value is y1, hai na? Now the particle moves at point D. Okay, again take a projection here. The new displacement will be y2 here. Okay, so it means again, when we take projection along x-axis, the oscillation is like this, and when we take projection along y-axis, the oscillation is like this. Okay, so what we conclude, that in the circular motion, the projection taken along y-axis or x-axis is having the simple harmonic motion. Yes, we have proved theoretically that simple harmonic motion, circular motion, when we take projection along y or x axis, the projection is having the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so now we will prove this statement mathematically. Okay, so for the mathematical proof of this statement, again take a circular path on which a particle is moving. Okay, again we have taken a circular path on which a particle is moving, and this circular motion is taken along, suppose xy plane. Okay, so this circular motion is taken in xy plane, suppose. Yes, now again take a particle, suppose it is at initial point A and it is at some initial angle from the x-axis. Suppose this initial angle is phi naught. Okay, this initial angle is phi naught. Suppose it is moving in anti-clockwise manner. After some time t, suppose the particle reaches at point P and suppose it has covered the angular displacement theta. Okay, so theta is equals to omega t. Theta is equals to omega t. Omega is the angular velocity, na? We know that, we have done in kinematics that omega, angular velocity is angular displacement divided by time taken. So how much is the angle covered by the object? It is equals to theta, and it is covered in time t with the angular velocity omega. So theta is omega t here. Okay, now suppose we take projection on the x-axis. Okay, take a projection on the x-axis. So suppose we have taken projection at point N, and suppose it is at a displacement of x. Okay, this projection is at a displacement of x. So this angle PON, what will be the value of this angle PON? This will be equals to, here the angle is phi naught, here the angle is theta. So angle PON will be equals to theta plus phi naught. And what is the value of theta? Theta is omega t plus phi naught. Okay, so angle PON is equals to omega t plus phi naught, or you can also write it as theta plus phi naught. Okay, so take the triangle PON. We have taken the triangle PON, OPN. We know that this value is x, and this value is suppose x. Suppose this particle is having the circular motion of radius small a. Okay, the radius of this circular path is suppose small a. So OP will be equals to small a, and this angle, we know that this angle is equals to omega t plus phi naught. This angle is equals to omega t plus phi naught. Okay. Okay, so take the value of cos omega t plus phi naught in the triangle PON. Take the value of cos omega t plus phi naught in the triangle PON. So what will be its value? Base by hypotenuse. We know that cos function is base by hypotenuse. So what is here in this triangle, opposite to this angle is perpendicular. Perpendicular making an angle of 90 degree with the side is base, and other side left is hypotenuse. So base by hypotenuse is this formula, na? So x divided by a, na? X is the base here, hypotenuse is this much length, and this much length is equals to a, which is this radius of this circular path. So find out the value of x from here. So x is equals to a cos omega t plus phi naught. So we have discussed if a function is represented in terms of cos or sine function, then that function is simple harmonic function. Okay, if a function is represented in terms of sine or cosine function, that is simple harmonic function. Okay, so x is the displacement of the particle. At which time the particle is at which position or which displacement, we can calculate from this equation. Okay, so x is equals to
a cos omega t plus phi naught. Okay. From this equation, you can calculate the velocity also. Okay.
We can calculate the velocity also from this equation. We know that v is equals to dx by dt. If the particle is having the angular displacement, it must be having the velocity. So how much is the velocity? We can calculate by differentiating this term. So x is equal, a is the constant, which is radius of circular path, that will not change. So take a as it is. What is the differentiation of cos function? Differentiation of cos function is minus sine. So minus sine omega t plus phi naught. Okay, and take the differentiation of this term also. So differentiation of omega t is omega, so multiply it here. So what we get, velocity equals to minus a omega sine omega t plus phi naught. Okay. Minus a omega sine omega t plus phi naught. Okay, so you can represent this velocity in various other forms, such as you can write this sine as, we know that sine x is equals to under root 1 minus cos square x, na? Sine x is equals to minus cos square x. So v is equals to minus a omega sine x can be written as under root 1 minus cos square x is omega t plus phi naught here, na? X is omega t plus phi naught here, but cos omega t plus phi naught is equals to x by a, na? Cos omega t plus phi naught is equals to cos omega t plus phi naught is equals to x by a. So what will be the value of square of this term? Square of this term is x square by a square. So v is equals to minus a omega under root 1 minus cos square omega t plus phi naught is equals to x square by a square. What is x here? A, x is the displacement. So this one is the another form in which you can represent the velocity. Velocity is equals to, take the LCM here. So if you take LCM, a square will be in the whole denominator. And a square comes here also. So under root of a square is a. So minus a omega under root of denominator a square. So it will come out as a under root a square minus x square. A square minus x square. A square cancel out. So what will be the value of velocity? Velocity is minus omega under root a square minus x square. Okay. So displacement is this. Displacement is x is equals to a cos omega t plus phi naught, है ना? X is equals to a cos omega t, here it is omega t. X is equals to a cos omega t plus phi naught. Okay. So velocity is this. In the similar way, you can find out the acceleration also. How can you find out the acceleration? We know that acceleration is dv by dt. So find out the acceleration by differentiating velocity. So differentiate the velocity term also. So we have calculated the value of velocity. So take differentiation of this term, minus a omega will be as it is. Take differentiation of sine ka. Differentiation of sine will be cos omega t plus phi naught. And differentiation omega t will be omega square. So this is the, here a is the acceleration. Okay, here a is the acceleration. A is the acceleration. And small a here is representing the radius of this circular path. So this is the formula for acceleration. Okay, so you can write it again in terms of x also. Okay, so there are various other forms in which we can represent this equation. Okay, yes, now we will find out the total energy in simple harmonic motion. So in simple harmonic motion, because the object or any particle is oscillating, it is having kinetic energy. And also it is having potential energy, because whenever the particle is displaced from the mean position, it always tries to return back to its original position. So the restoring force is acting on the particle. So due to that restoring force, potential energy is stored in it. So let's find out the value of kinetic energy and potential energy. So of simple harmonic motion. For simple harmonic motion, as we know that kinetic energy is equals to half mv square. Okay. So just in the previous topic, we have calculated the value of velocity. We will directly put the value of velocity. Okay, so velocity was, if we square the value of velocity, what we will get? M by 2 omega square a square omega square small a square sin square omega t plus phi naught. Okay, omega square a square sin square omega t plus phi naught. Okay, so this is the value for kinetic energy. So you can represent it in another form also. For example, kinetic energy can also be written in the term of x is equals to a sin omega t plus phi naught. We know that x is equals to a sin omega t plus phi naught. Okay, so put the value of x here. Okay, we will put the value of x here. If we take projection on x axis, okay, so if we take projection on x axis, we obtain the result that was observed earlier, and if we take projection on y axis, the result is as such. Okay, so put a sin omega t plus phi naught equals to x. So kinetic energy will be equals to m omega square by 2 m omega square by 2 a square minus x square. Okay, so kinetic energy in other form you can represent it as m omega square by 2 a square minus x square. Okay, m omega square by 2 a square minus x square. You can use this term also, you can use whatever term you are familiar with. Next is potential energy. So potential energy is equals to work done, and work done is equals to integration of f dx. Here the force acting is taken as restoring force. Okay, force acting is taken as restoring force, and this force is the applied force. The applied force is in the opposite direction of restoring force. So integrate with restoring force is equals to minus a kx, but opposite of this is taken as plus kx. So f is equals to kx dx. Okay, so integrate it within the limits 0 to x. Okay, so work done is equals to kx square divided by 2. So this is the potential energy. Above is the term of the kinetic energy. So these are the kinetic and potential energies stored in a simple harmonic oscillator. Okay. Next, we will find out the time period of a simple pendulum. Okay, time period of a simple pendulum. Suppose we have a simple pendulum, and this is the mean position of the pendulum. Suppose it is displaced through a very small angle. Okay, so what were the forces acting on this? So forces acting on this is, suppose theta is the displacement produced in the, this is the mean position, this is the new position of the pendulum. Okay, so force acting is in the downward direction. So how much is the force? Gravitational force is acting in the downward direction, na? So it is mg. Now extend this line also. So this will also be equals to theta. Okay, and we will have the components of mg, mg cos theta, and here is mg sin theta, mg sin theta. So the bob of the pendulum is coming back to its mean position because of the force
mg sin theta. Okay, it is coming back because of the force mg sin theta. So the role of restoring force is played by the force mg sin theta. Okay, minus mg sin theta. Now this derivation, while deriving the time period of a simple pendulum, we are assuming that this angular displacement is very small. So we know that in mathematical it is there that if angle is small, sin theta is approximately equals to theta. So you can write mg theta. Okay, now as we know that theta is equals to arc by radius, na theta is equals to arc by radius. Okay, so suppose this is length of this pendulum is suppose smaller. Okay, so length of this pendulum is smaller, and this is the here length of the pendulum is smaller. Okay, and this is the displacement x, and this is the angle theta. So theta is also equals to angle is equals to arc by radius, na. So theta is equals to x by l, na. Theta is equals to x by l. So replace theta by x by l. Mg x divided by l. So f is equals to minus mg x by l. Also f is equals to mass into acceleration. So mass into acceleration is equals to minus mg x divided by l. So cancel m from m here. So what will you get? A is equals to, A will be equals to minus g by l into x. So A is directly proportional to x, na. So it means oscillation of simple pendulum at small angle also represents the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so you can find out the time period also. So time period for a simple pendulum is equals to 2 pi by omega, time period is equals to 2 pi by omega. So here A is equals to minus g by l. So put g by l equals to omega square. Put g by l is equals to omega square. So what will be the value of omega? Omega will be equals to under root g by l. So 2 pi omega is equals to under root g divided by l. So what we will get from here? 2 pi under root l by g. So time period of a pendulum depends on the length of the pendulum. Okay, time period of a simple pendulum depends on the length of the pendulum. Okay, next is there are two definitions only. One is free oscillation and one is damped oscillation. What is free oscillation? Free oscillation, just like the oscillation happening in a string of a guitar. Okay, so when you apply a force, then the object starts vibrating on its natural frequency. Okay, that type of oscillation is known as free oscillation or undamped oscillation. In this free oscillation, amplitude is always the same. Okay, amplitude of oscillation is always the same. Amplitude of oscillation is always the same. Next is undamped oscillation. So what are undamped oscillation? So if the amplitude decreases every time, then that kind of oscillation is known as damped oscillation. Okay, so amplitude is not same in the damped oscillation, but amplitude is same in undamped oscillation. Okay, in damped oscillation the amplitude will be decreasing with time, and ultimately the vibrations will die off very soon. So in this way this chapter is completed. Tomorrow we will do our last chapter, which is the chapter waves. Thank you.